Big changes happening to the CSR in Halo 5 and how it can match up better with your MMR, so your ranks will actually hopefully go up and down accordingly. Will this update to the CSR gained in ranked matches really kind of solve the frustration the community has been feeling with the ranks in Halo 5? Or will this update just be more of a band-aid to what we've been kind of dealing with for the last about year almost with the new ranking system? Stay tuned throughout the entire video to find all the little details. How's it going, everybody? It's Kevin here once again giving you another commentary, talking about some news updates with Halo 5 and the ranking system in CSR and the big changes coming for you guys, where it could be a little bit more incremental rather than so cut and dry like it was previously. If you enjoyed these news update videos, please make sure to tap that like button. It lets me know you want to see some more content like this. Leave a comment down below where your thoughts are currently on the CSR ranking MMR system that we have right now in Halo 5, because I know people who have been playing this game certainly have their opinions. I do as well, and I will express them in this video. And if you want to stay up to date with anything Halo related, please make sure to tap subscribe on the channel as you get to know anything that's happening with Halo. So let's get right into the video here. Recently, Josh Mankey, the engagement lead at 343, posted a update on Halo Wave Point, talking about the changes that they're going to be making to the CSR, where currently, as we all know right now, that according to your MMR, if you're in a certain kind of win-loss ratio predicted match, your CSR will either go up 15 or down 15 or up 1 or minus 1, depending on the kind of players you're playing against. This was a big change from the previous system, which was just, if you win, you go up, if you lose, you go down. But the problem was that I didn't take in part individual skill. They involved a lot of players with their rank game boosted a lot higher because they probably played in a full party. Now, that system did seem rather fair, because if you win, you go up, you lose, you go down, but it didn't really give truly accurate numbers for player skill. And that's what we recently tried changing in Halo 5 with adding true skill to MMR and changing up the ranking system a little bit. So not only is win and losses ultimately the most important thing, but also individual skill and how well you play in that match. Though a lot of players now have been kind of finding a lot of frustration with this, saying, I played well against people what I see are my rank, but I don't rank up. What's the problem? And so it's been causing a lot of confusion. I will say that front end wise of the matchmaking system and ranking system, it can be very confusing. And so that's why with this recent update, what they're going to do is try to make that a little bit more sensible. So now the recent update is, instead of going either up 15 or down 15 or plus 1, minus 1, you'll have an incremental upgrade between up to 30 or up or down to 30 on your CSR. So you can gain 27 CSR, you can gain 13 CSR, you can lose 30 CSR, you can lose 12 CSR. It's a gradient now rather than so cut and dry. The whole point about this is that they find that the MMR seems to be doing rather well when it comes to matchmaking, and I would agree with that as well. I've been finding ever since this MMR True Skill 2 has been implemented with MMR that I've been finding a lot more fair matches, that's for sure. I've been getting a lot more matches that are kind of in my skill range. Though, I've been finding some frustration when it comes to ranking up, because it seems like whenever I get to like the top end of my MMR where I should be and I win a match, oftentimes I'll just gain 1 CSR, and if I lose, I'll definitely lose 15 CSR, so I have pretty much everything to lose and a little bit to gain. Well, what they're trying to do with this update is to try to make it so you can be a little, you can gain a little bit, lose a little bit, kind of be more flexible, as quoted by Josh Mankey, as less draconian, as in less harsh when it comes to getting your wins or your losses on your rank. Now, I have been playing since this update has been out, and I will say, like, I go up, I go down a little bit, I'm hovering right around Diamond 1 in Team Arena right now. And I do feel like I can be a little bit, I can rank up a little bit higher, but I've come across again still the issue of where I win a game and I go up like 1, maybe 2, maybe 5 CSR at the most kind of thing. As you can see in this graph, these are the last 9 matches I've played in Team Arena, and I've only lost 3 of those. But I started out the play session at Diamond 1, and so I kind of got stuck in Plat 6. Though yes, some of my KDs were not the best, but I'm still playing against players at my skill level, and I'm not really ranking up a whole lot. And that seems to be the biggest frustration when it comes to players in this new CSR MMR True Skill 2 setup that we have in this game. I do feel like I'm getting fair matches, I just feel like a lot of times I'm not getting compensated properly for winning my matches, because I have no control over who I get in my match. And just because I had a 1 kill death ratio doesn't mean I played poorly and should barely rank up. And the hard better part about this is that there is no cut and dry formula or simple reason why you go up or go down. It's all dependent on that match and that context with those players in this situation. So like I said, I've been getting a lot more fair matches, like, but the biggest issue is the compensation just wasn't quite there. Now there are a lot of variables to take in consideration, so it's not completely all Menki's fault why I'm not enjoying Arena as much as I can, because I'm getting good matches, it's just I'm not getting the rank ups like I was kind of hoping for. But you know, I still play the game because Halo 5 is awesome. I love playing Team Arena in the game, and so I'm going to keep playing it because it's awesome. Which, by the way, if you want to check it out, I do stream it quite often on my Twitch channel. First link in the description down below. We can go check it out there if you guys would like to check that out. I do stream mainly at night, like 9 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. Hope to see you guys there. But anyways, continue on with the video here. There was also another change that happened with the quitting penalties that happened in Halo 5 as well, which I really appreciate because I absolutely hate it when people quit in 4v4 matches. It's absolutely frustrating. Being down a player in Halo is absolutely just like blows your game out of the water and you have no chance of coming back almost. Well, hopefully with this update, if you guys like this video, hopefully more people get to know more about it, that apparently if you're the first person who leaves in a match, you get docked minus 30 points on a penalty that alone, and then on top of that you lose the CSR that you lose from that match. You get hit really hard for leaving matches, which I am all for that. People quitting out of a match should just like, you should just take the penalty because you should either know you need at least 12 minutes to play a game, or you shouldn't quit out because you're not playing well. So now you're probably thinking, well, what if it's a 3v4 and I'm on the team of 3? Do I still get that 30 penalty loss? No, you only lose the CSR you lose from if you would have lost that match anyways. So you don't get an extra 30 penalty like the first person who leaves, which is really good to know. So if someone leaves a match and it's like almost gone, or you guys are going to lose anyways, just back out. You might get a quit penalty though for the timing, because obviously there's that issue if you back out too many times, you get penalized and banned for a temporary amount of time, but you only lose the CSR of the match you would have lost anyway. And say if a match starts 3v4 and a team with 3 people or less leaves, there's no leaving penalty on that one either, but you still get the lost penalty, if that all makes sense, hopefully. So now what do I think about this gradient scale of CSR gaining? I think it's better than what we were dealing with before, but the hard 15, plus or minus, or plus or minus 1. I felt like once you get to like the high end of your MMR kind of where like the game kind of figures out your skill level between the CSR and MMR lineup, that it was really hard to rank up. And if you lost one match, it would take you probably another 15 matches to get back to where you were, at least sometimes, depending on players you match, obviously. Now with this gradient here, it does make things, probably a little bit more fair. It probably hopefully give you a little bit more accurate representation of what your CSR is, because now you get an accurate number of, okay, you won this match, but when you played against weaker players, you get 12 CSR, or you're a platinum one and you beat an Onyx guy, yeah, you get plus 30 CSR on that one. The biggest issue is that the CSR and MMR need to really line up perfectly, because on our end, what we're seeing is that we get matched against these players who are in our rank and we barely rank up. That's the frustrating part about the whole thing. Now you can say, well, actually those players you're playing against were, more your level or more this level, it's just that their, MMR CSR is a little bloated. Well, that's the problem with the whole situation though, is that it's that they're not lining up properly. So on our end, players get really frustrated when I play a match full of diamond tier players and I gain like 2 CSR. It's kind of frustrating when I feel like I should be gaining 30. If that's the case, I don't know what really would constitute winning 30 points in a CSR within a game. Do I have to be Onyx players to get 30? Do I just have to be players within my rank to earn 30 points? We'd like to low a little bit more in that kind of end of details when it comes to the posts, maybe in the future, Menki, just letting you know. But, overall, I think it's a great change. Hopefully it'll give us a little more accurate representation of our skill of CSR and MMR, but hopefully it all works out in the end. So I'm still going to be playing the game because obviously I love playing Halo 5. But what do you guys think about this update to the CSR in Halo 5? Do you think it's a good change? Do you think this will help me level out the skills and MMR to kind of line up more properly? Or do you think it'll help probably just alleviate some frustration some players are feeling? Because I know Menki gets a lot of hate on Twitter for how often people don't gain their CSR or lose their CSR in Halo 5. So leave it in the comment section down below. I do read all the comments and try to reply the most them as well. If you enjoyed this video, find out information and want more people to know about this whole CSR ranking situation, please make sure to tap that like button, as it greatly helps out this video and the channel so more people stay in the know, and helps out, lets me know you want to see some more videos like this. And if you're new to the channel, want to stay up to date with anything Halo related, make sure to tap subscribe to the channel, as we stay everything up to date with anything Halo related. Check out the videos on the screen right over here. If you missed any content from me, or if you're new, I'll catch you all in the next video. Peace out.